Main direction running north to south, and then there's a minor direction, side direction running east to west. And the colored bars show you where the cars have to wait. So in American terms, you would probably have the actual signal C on the other side of the intersection. In Germany, there would be like a pole that overhangs the road. But in sumo, we have an abstraction. We show you the end of the edge where the cars have to wait. So it's always there at the border of the intersection. What you will find in your NetXML is this. And this is basically the abstraction that sumo uses to define a static traffic light cycle. So there's a number of phases, and they each run, they are active for some time, and when the cycle is through, it repeats from the start. So you get a sequence of signal states, and that's that. Now, we're looking at these things for a bit, so I'll have to explain what we see there. So first of all, it's a static plan, indicated here by this attribute. It's actually one program for the traffic light. So for a single traffic light, you could have multiple programs, switch between them. There's even something you can load in sumo that switches between programs automatically after a set time. Like, you have the morning program and you have the evening program. I'm not sure if that's common in America, but it's something that German cities sometimes have. And then there's an offset, which means basically when you start the simulation, at what part of the cycle is it going to be? Because if you want to signalize a corridor, you may want to set up a greenway, and so you want to shift these relative to each other. So that's what the offset is for. Now it gets a bit more interesting. You see this list of letters. That's basically the signal states of the traffic light. And you see G, that's for green, very suggestively, and then R for red, and you see the Y for yellow. So these are all the states the signal is going to take. There's a dark green and a light green, indicated by a major G, capital G, and a minor G. What that is for, I'm going to explain in a little while. And then you see that there are these numbers. They set up, let's say, names of each of the signals that are used to control this intersection. And basically, these letters correspond to these numbers. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to 11. So there are 12 different signals here. And why that is, I'm going to explain in a little while. And then you have these durations. So that's basically a static cycle. The sequence of states that are kept for a certain time, and then after that, they change. All right. Then we have actuated traffic lights. Well, actually, it's a bit of a misnomer, because actuated is an abstract thing. There are tons of different ways to have an actuated traffic light. Actuated in the sense that the traffic on the road influences the way the traffic light works. But in sumo, for historical reasons, there's a particular type of algorithm that's indicated by this type. So when you select that, it's in the junction attributes here, so you have a junction of type traffic light, and then you can switch between static and this other type that would be actuated. What really changes here? Well, obviously the type. And then you have additional attributes here. You have a minimum duration and a maximum duration for a phase. And as you can see here, there are some phases that don't have any G, not any green in them, and they don't have a variable duration. These are the transitions, they always last for the same time, but the states with the G's in them, they can be shorter or longer. That's the main idea behind the actuation. You can vary the duration of the phase in response to the traffic on the road. So that should be pretty clear. And yesterday, some people talked about the delay-based algorithm. I showed that, those four examples. So in that list, not shown here because it's cut off, there's also a type delay-based So you can select that, and that's basic, that's actually the algorithm for an actuated traffic light controller. That then type delay. All right. So now I said Sumo does things a bit differently, and I'm trying to lay out in detail what these things are. So first of all, why are there these 12 things, 12 different things? On the road, you probably only have two lights per road, one for the left lane, one for the right lane. But this is because Sumo adds a different little letter for each lane-to-lane connection. And if you go back here, you see, if you count these arrows, there are 12 arrows. So even though the straight and the right are controlled in reality by a single light and the drivers just know how to interpret them, and soon we make this very explicit, there are two connections to take and there are two signal states. Actually, that's not the whole truth. There's a way to group them, but that goes beyond the first part. All right, so that's the first thing. You get all these little states for each lane to lane. There is a distinction in the section control between the green light, where drivers still have to yield to oncoming traffic. I think you call that yield on left turn, yield on green. In German, it's bedingte Verträglichkeit. Very nice word.
That's great.
So basically,
it flows from the tongue.
You have a green light, but in one case, you really have the right of way. In the other case, you still have to look for traffic. So in real life, at least in Germany, sometimes this is made visible to the driver with additional lighting, additional infrastructure on the road. So the driver has to look at multiple things to figure out what state the intersection is in. In Sumo, we make this very explicit. For each connection, we say, is it currently an exclusive green, or is it a green where, with the yield? So this is this. And now, the most difficult thing to grasp is that Sumo does not distinguish between phases and phase transitions. Every time a single light changes its state, we call that a new phase. So in Sumo terms, a phase is a distinct vector of states. However, you can give these phases names to distinguish the transition from the main phase. So we call this the main phase, and then the left turn phase, and then maybe the phase for the secondary road. And these other phases then would be the transition with the yellow light for 3 seconds. All right. And now when NetConvert generates traffic lights for you, let's say from an OpenStreetMap network, or because you click change the node type to traffic light, it will give you these yellow phases, these yellow transitions, but it won't give you a phase where all the lights are red, which is important for large intersections because our cars need to clear them. For historical reasons, these aren't there, but there's an option to add them automatically. And now the last thing is, I'm not sure how the traffic engineering software, the traffic light engineering software that you are using works, but typically you have multiple lines. Each line is for one signal head, and then in the horizontal you have the timings. I'm not sure if that's how your software typically looks. Let's see. I can get this in Sumo probably. So let's set this to a traffic light. Open this up. And so something like this, right? Each signal is a line. These are too many, but
did you add
probably we'll only have 8 and not 12. And then on the horizontal, you have the time. But in Sumo, this grouping is the other way around. It's transposed, if you will. So here in one line are all the different signals, and the time is running in that direction. So just make sure to understand that this is different from what you are used to. All right. Now, what can you do in the graphical user interface? I just did some clicking very fast, so let's do this again slowly. First of all, this is what you're going to see. You see in the simulation these colored bars, and that's it. But you know this little rainbow button? It will give you lots of options that help dealing with traffic lights. So that's in the junction category. The one thing you can check is this show lane-to-lane connection. It will give you all these arrows. Sometimes they're still hard to read, especially for the turnarounds, because it's a very small straight line from there to there. It's still a help. Then you can activate this numbering. This will give you the numbers. I think you cannot see them, so let's make them bigger. Maybe you can see them now. There are actually three numbers here, though. 9, 10, 11 are squished on top of each other. Yeah. So these are this is the numbering that also is used in this state sequence. Then you can activate this. And this will show you the current phase index. So that would be that would tell you if you are in this one, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so which of these phases are you in? And if you define names, then it would also show the name of the phase.
I just changed it. That's red.
I don't know. To be completely honest, I don't know.
Jacob, I didn't have any traffic signal, so the first thing I did is I did a drop down for TL type on my junction, and I clicked on static, but it's red now.
You first need to change the type of the junction. So there's a junction type, and then there's a traffic light type.
Ah, okay.
First set it to traffic light, then you can change it to static.
Got it. Okay. Enter. F5. Ah, hey.
Okay. All right.
So now did you get the traffic light button?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's do this here again. So show the connections, I show these numbers, and I show the phase.
Still don't get the
names.
The file failed as traffic light.
Which we need to create
as far as what?
File.
Which directions?
I can tell you. Hit the little color wheel. Go to junction.
I'll come to that.
Scroll down. Show the TL and say next and change it to a size 100. And then click OK. Screw zoom in. You should be able to see it. Is that what you were asking?
Oh, yeah. In this file,
how do I know which one of these is which? Oh, wait. It's because it's colored.
Ah,
good call. I just
want
to show you the names here. So
this one is.
We'll get to that.
That's the main one. So I'm going to make that.
Yeah. Let's go back to this one.
6,000.
All right. So these are the things you can do to change the visualization. And there's another thing you can do. If you click on that, on those colored bars, that is. You can, again, get the context menu, and there you have several options. For example, you can switch off the traffic light. I mean, in a serious simulation, you would not want to rely on clicking. But for testing, that can be done.
I have one question for you. Is the traffic light files, are they TLS files or TLL?
TLL, but
okay.
I'll come to that in a little bit.
Sorry.
No problem. So what you can do is show the phases that have been defined in the current program. So you can also track the phases as they advance. So now when I run the simulation, won't let me run because I didn't define any traffic, but then you get the sequence of signal states here in this tracker window. And is where it gets interesting. If you had multiple programs defined for the traffic light, you could also switch between them in the graphical user interface. All right. So you were asking about files. And the first thing I'm going to show you is that the traffic light plan is part of the network. So whenever you have a traffic light, then in the network file there is some plan defined.
So you don't need to include it in the config file.
Right.
Okay.
However, if you want a different plan, you can add this from a configuration file. So you say here I have my network, and then I have my clever new plan, and I don't want to put this in my network because I change it all the time, and then I load it as an additional file. So that's typically the way how to include multiple programs for a traffic light. You load them from another file. When you load them, the last thing you loaded will be the thing Sumo starts with. Okay. Oh, I wanted to show you how it looks when I switch it up. Then you get different colors. The light blue basically means these would get right away. They wouldn't have to do anything like a priority intersection now. And the brownish things, they would have to yield. In Germany, that would correspond to the light is switched off, and on the side the light is blinking, and then the drivers know, oh, now we're in a priority intersection mode.
Huh? It's awful, but it's a simple static
all right.
Thing here. Stop it. What? The U-turn thing? I know, it's kind of goofy, right? But it's actually helped me troubleshoot a whole lot.
Now, I wanted to tell you what you can do with the traffic lights that are automatically generated. Because when you run the NetGenerate or the web browser, or even when you just change the junction type in NetEdit, you will get some single plan. And how that's going to look depends on these options. So for example, you can change the default cycle time. The default value is 90 seconds, so all the lights in your network will have a 90 second cycle. You can change that. Also, the default type. Are they all going to be static or are they all going to be actuated? Change it here. This is more interesting. Not only are there different algorithms, there are also different typical phase diagrams. Let's show them in an example.
I'll load my traffic.
Jacob?
Yes?
We got 1 hour left until we need to finish this to...
I think we'll manage.
Okay.
I think it is here, but you have to be in traffic signal editor. So if I click on my junction here, what is...
I have a
question.
I'm not sure whether I'm going to be much use in the traffic light section.
What is this button right here?
Yeah, see? Mode for select elements.
Ah, okay, so I don't want S. Okay, so escape, S escape, got it. I wish
right,
you could
so
hover and they would tell you.
We have a signal plan here.
Does it?
I'm showing you how it looks.
I was looking for it up there.
Down
below.
Yeah, yeah.
There's a mode for that.
So if I click
the traffic light mode.
Inspect.
Letter T.
Here. It is a traffic light.
When you
it's a standard.
First go into this mode.
Okay.
It's just going
so
to show you the time
so it is already
right
here.
In
so I was
to help you quickly see which of the intersections I actually control.
It just wasn't apparent that.
And then once you click on that intersection.
Because if I go back to
you're going to see the state.
But there actually is a signal.
So I'm going to make this a little
wider. Because S is a selection mode, which is usually just used for
what's
selecting edges.
Got it. Okay, so here's
the
method. I think it holds each time,
it's
just
that
it doesn't show up.
That's why it has these extra columns, minimum, maximum. If you have a static traffic light, you won't see these values. You will just see the
But I haven't
the
played with any of my actuations.
And I can...
We know one other thing I haven't done.
I already see how it's going to look like. So when I do it like this, I don't have to remember the numbers. I can just look at the color field. Then I can click and change the durations, of course. would change the maximum duration here to 60. And save that. No,
so
there's an extra save button here. Just save the changes you did. Then you still have to change the save the network file. This is just so you can go back from what you were doing.
So my signal.
All right. So let's look at that at this particular sequence.
I have no idea.
We have a phase for this main direction.
I don't know how you edit the detectors.
And then in this phase, the left turns, they have to yield. They can drive, but they have to yield to the oncoming traffic. And actually also to the right turn. Then we have a transition where all the straight and right going traffic has to stop. And then we have this exclusive turning phase. And then we have another phase where the side direction is active. And if you look closely, then you will see that again the left turns have to yield. And since there are no actual turning lanes, the algorithm automatically decided that there should not be an extra phase for the left turns, because what if there were vehicles going straight and then there was this useless left turn phase? So that's why this only has three main phases. That was automatic. Now, that was the layout opposites, because the opposite directions get to drive at the same time. If you were set this option to this layout option to incoming, then you would get a plan where each direction, each incoming road, gets its own phase. I'll show you how that looks like. So thereby I also show you how to edit these plans. I right click here and I split them all off. I right click here and I set them all to green. So that would be one phase. And then I would get set all these to green, all these to red. That would be another phase. And then again, I would have a phase where the cars from the east drive and one phase for the car where the cars from the west drive. That would be another way to get the cycle where everybody gets to drive eventually. I think in some countries, they all work like this. I think in Thailand, all the traffic lights have a separate phase for each direction. So that's just how they do it there. You can change this by clicking on a whole edge that changes all the connections that start from there, but you can also click on these connections to just change a single one. So these are ways of doing it. You can also click here and change the letters. So this is how you would work with that, and this is how it's interpreted. All right, then there are other options. You can disable building these extra left turning phases if you set the green time to zero, or you can sell all the left turn phases that should have a default length of whatever. You can add a time where all the lights are red to give a clearance during the transitions. And then there are options for controlling the duration of the yellow time. By default, they are based on the road speed. All right. And I guess the all red time should also be based on the junction size. That's not in there. Okay. Any questions so far?
Yeah. We don't know how to do the detectors on the actuator. I think we got through the static. One thing I can't figure out, so it sounds like the traffic lights are inside the net file, but I saved a TLL file, and I don't even know if I got that right outside. I don't know how to add that in my Sumo config to incorporate that, and I don't think you do. Is that?
Yes, you add it as an additional file.
Okay, so it would be an additional. Okay, so I would have another add. But then the actuated one, we missed the detector part for
right,
sure.
I'll show you that. The detector part is implicit. So let's go back.
So if I go back to my I for inspection mode, click on the intersection, and instead of being static, I'm going to do actuated, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I'll show you how the detectors are working in Sumo Group. So,
I think he's talking about net edit.
Yeah, the point is, these detectors, they are implicit. You don't need to define them. Whenever you define an actuated traffic light, when you load it in Sumo, it's going to create these detectors for you. And there are additional parameters for controlling where they are.
That's what I'd like to...
But you never need to define them as an addition in an additional file.
Okay. All right, so now if I change it to actuate and I hit the signal and then click on this, see, I'm not seeing any, right?
Are you holding them out there? Okay. The way where you configure
so
these detectors and all the parameters of the actuation algorithm, it's working with the time gap.
Hit that.
There are options for that.
Static. Change that static.
And there in the documentation.
But now,
but
should it not be in like you have now the
really
option here between min and max where you prolong
if
your phase?
They're here, yeah. I think
they're
all that.
And if you're going to hit control T,
traffic management
to
and other structures,
open
traffic lines.
It doesn't work on this version because
oh,
of the
just,
space.
Yeah.
That,
fix it. Just
you could ever want to know.
Fix it in the next version. It's going to work.
And then the actuator traffic light section and tells you all the options that you can set. About all the gaps, how should they be? Should they even write output these special detectors? And yeah, so you read that up in the documentation. I'm not gonna go over the details here.
But if you open this one up in Sumo,
further
okay.
questions.
So let me see my network.
Yeah.
I'm gonna close this. So now this XML, this TLL, this is bogus right here. I could add that in if I wanted to, but let me double check. So in my net, I want to make sure I got this right.
It should be in your net.
So in the simple net XML, if I come down through here, when I get down to the green, yellow, red, this is actuated right here.
Yeah.
But now the detectors, I wonder where those are.
It's creating them when it's loading them, but it's when it's loading the network.
So I'll do this here. So you're saying fire off Sumo.
Yeah.
Okay, so now Sumo config, fire this thing off.
I changed this section here.
Why is there none, but... Oh, no, those are my detectors I put in. Those are E1 detectors.
Right.
Just
let's
edge ones.
Here,
yeah, but the same ones are
now,
used for the traffic
detection.
No, like,
traffic.
This is the wrong way right
so
here.
So, I go back to
so,
the inspection mode.
Like, if you look, like, these
I
ones I just put
in
for the capture. Like, this is outbound and outbound.
Okay, we just have to...
I'll play
okay.
it here. Let's see
back.
If it actually works, but...
I have this min and max value.
Now this one here is weird. Like this one right. is not supposed to control
now,
anything.
Those are E1 detectors. Those are data outputs.
Yeah.
Those aren't related to the
those
same.
Are not part of your traffic lights.
No.
Can you make a right click
anyway,
on this one?
That's not part
right.
of the signal
yeah.
either.
But this one here.
That one's not either. I put that one in.
You can build a controller that controls multiple detectors.
Wait, once again, in the network file.
So, I'm going to close
this.
Yeah.
If you have...
So you want this file?
The cluster of intersections that are very close to each other.
Yeah.
Sometimes
okay.
we get this one open.
See, these are my E detectors. I had 1, 2, and 3. Those are
those. Yeah. Very close to each other.
But I have no idea where the detectors are
for
the signal. That part I'm pretty bummed about.
So
further down.
The way to do this?
The traffic lights, no? Yeah, traffic light.
I'll show you. Let's say.
Ah, you have the junction with this traffic light?
This right here. So it's a traffic light junction, but there's nothing about detectors on this.
No, this is a static one.
Well, these are just just conflicts. These are just compatibility here that they were showing up. This is at the...
Yeah.
So this is just a junction stuff. So the only thing I have in here is an actuated
right.
with the min, max, and all that.
We
I follow
have two
that.
Sections that are very, very close
but
to each other.
The problem I don't
and
have...
And they're both traffic
there's
lights.
There's nothing about detectors.
Let's make sure of that.
I'm not sure. I think they're going to be created on
so
the
right now,
on the
there
fly.
Are two different lights, right?
We need to ask.
One here,
yeah,
one there.
That was unclear.
But I would prefer to control them on the single algorithm because they're always in sync. So what I do is I look here, and this traffic light has actually an ID. Right now it's called the same way as the junction, but I'm just going to give it a new name. I'm going to call it join, so you know what it's about. And then I go here and call that join as well. So now I have two junctions that have the same traffic light name. Now when I click here, well, they're actually one. So
I'm not sure
no matter where I click,
I didn't get any of it.
I get them both. So the number of states here is in 3.
I couldn't adjust them at all.
And I can
traffic
define lights the phase
actuated
of the
so doing these things, does it need to be a T intersection both of them? Or like it can
arbitrary.
Be
whatever. You can put all the intersections in the network and control them with a single controller. It would probably not be a good idea, but you could do it. Further questions to that?
Okay, I missed that part. I'm still struggling on the detectors.
And the only thing he did is he picked one of them, named it like the same, you know.
The same name, and it linked it.
You just have to remember there's one more attribute here. So we have the junction type, that's a traffic light. We have the traffic light type, that's static, and then we have those two other attributes here.
Oh, okay.
That's the name of the traffic light controller. And if two junctions, then our traffic lights have the same controller name, well, then there's one controller.
Okay.
All right. Are there further questions so far?
Yes. So, on the left turn, I'm turning on the state. It's a green, green, red, red. Are the left turn is always protected or permissive?
That's the coloring. You see?
Yeah, the green ones are protected.
The dark green ones, now the bright green ones are detected, they're called green major here, and the dark green ones, they are unprotected. So
if I want to give them another phase, how do I do that?
You add a new phase. So in this example here, in this plan, there is already a protected phase. And if you want more phases, well, you can insert them. Insert phases, delete phases as much as you want. And then you have to define the new states for these phases. Mm-hmm. Does that answer the question? Yeah. Further questions? And let's move on to outputs. So, outputs relating to traffic lights is again outputs that refers to a particular location. So you're not going to switch it on just with a sumo option, but you'll have to define these outputs in an additional file. Recall how we did it with the edge data and the detectors. So in such a file, where you would define detectors, you could also define these additional outputs here. So these output definitions would lead to these files containing information about traffic light states.
So that add and slash add, I need to have another add file, or do I just go into my one add file that I have?
You can do both. You can load multiple additional files, or you can put everything in one file, whatever serves your interest best.
Okay.
Sometimes for organizational purposes, it's better to separate these things. And so these outputs, they will pretty much just track what the traffic light is doing. They will tell you when did it switch and what state did it switch to, which is not terribly interesting for a static traffic light because you know already what it's going to do. But for an actuated traffic light, it may be interesting to they have these outputs to track how often did it switch and how long did it keep each phase. But I guess what you're really interested in is in how was the traffic affected by that one particular traffic light? So how much time loss was there around that traffic light? And the thing here is it's not as comfortable as it could be. Basically, you'll have to add all these detectors that we already talked about before, the area detectors that track what's happening on a part of a lane. You have to add them for every lane around the traffic light and then analyze those outputs. The good news though is you don't have to define them yourself in NetEdit or in the text file. They are tools. So basically you run such a Python tool and then it will add detectors around every traffic light. Let's say there's an option. There are options that tell you where you can set. Well, I want to track 50 meters around every traffic light, or 100 meters around every traffic light. So this is what you could do with these tools. But it's still a bit of a work to analyze this data, because then you still have to check if you just want to look at the left turns, which are the left turn detectors, to analyze those. I guess what I do most often is I look at small scenarios, and then I just use the aggregated statistics. If I just have one traffic light or two interested in this corridor, then I can use the aggregated result of the whole simulation. Check what is the time loss, the overall time loss of all vehicles, to get my metrics. I saw a skeptical look there. Go ahead.
I'm still stuck on the detectors. I know I'm frustrated there, so I'll...
You did get the fact that you don't have to define them.
But I want to be able to set the distance. I want to set where they're, how long they are, the amount of time. And so I can't see them, and I don't know how to reference them, and I don't know how to input them. So.
Okay. Right. The first thing you can easily do is right-click on this traffic light, and then you can select show detectors, and it will.
Okay, so you're in Sumo. You're not in NetEdit.
I'm in Sumo. Right. You won't see them in NetEdit.
Okay.
I guess that would be useful, but it's not
in NetEdit.
I guess yes, it would be useful.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
In NetEdit, but right now you only see them in the group.
So those detectors that exist without
show detectors.
Right.
So you have to click on the traffic light.
From all those detectors.
Yes, yes, you
yeah,
can.
Make a right
okay.
click there.
Because,
show detectors.
There is.
Got it.
Now I got more.
There are Sumo options.
So one. Two, three, four. But I'd like to be able to move it.
In your traffic light definition.
Okay.
So if you want to define it for each traffic light.
So those detectors are also named under the same name for the same for traffic light?
I think the name is created from the traffic light and the lane, because each lane gets a different detector.
Okay.
But what you really need is the... For analysis purposes,
you do need
the detector.
Yes.
But it's a very easy
box.
You will figure it out from the name when you see.
So I just right clicked and showed the detectors, and I can see them, and they're placed like no way like how I would have them here. So that's why I want to be able to edit them and reference them and do things like that.
When you say they're not placed as you would place them, that may be because you would use them with a different algorithm. I mean, in this case, this is a very specific traffic light control algorithm. And it uses these detectors in a very specific way. So.
But let me give you an example. Like a left turn, I want that detector right at the stop bar. If I'm at a 55 mile an hour or 100 kilometers per hour, it's going to be 5 seconds back from there. So I want to be able to position that thing like way back on the link or the edge.
Yeah. There is this parameter. I think it's the C. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong algorithm. That was delay based. So I think that would be the detector gap value. It's a value in seconds. So it's basically how many seconds before the vehicle encounters the stop bar is the detector placed. So, well, there's a reason for that. It's quite logical when you look at the exact algorithm, but I think it's a little bit too detailed here right now. But again, it's just one traffic light algorithm. If you have specific ideas on how you want to do it, you either have to add another algorithm to Sumo, or you have to control it remotely via tracing, which is the next point I'm coming to.
Okay.
So this actuated traffic light, it does not give you a lot of flexibility.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a way for a Sumo simulation to have better traffic lights than the static ones.
Okay.
And just one building blocks that we built.
They're generated without reference to any traffic information. So by that nature, they don't work too well. And so if you have this ready newly generated network with these actuated traffic lights just will have better traffic.
In the view settings, is there any way to specify that the detectors are on whenever you open it? Or do you have to...
Actually, it's a, since this is a per detector thing, usually, it's not in the view settings, but there's a sumo option. It's called show detector or something or other. Let's see. Should be here somewhere. No, it's not there. Just too many options.
Sorry to be a drag on this one. This is what I spend, I think, majority of my life.
All right, so this is the option. TLS.actuated.show-detectors. If you add that option, then they will all be visible at the start of the simulation.
Can I put that in my computer?
Yeah, this was that, but I was just, can we put this in the sumo configuration file? Is there an element for it?
Well, you just, well, for every option that you can give, you can always put it in the XML file. You
okay.
Just get rid of the leading double dash
and add a
value
equal
to true
action.
If it's a Boolean option.
Yeah.
So,
okay.
So you can, of course, you can put this in your computer.
Okay, so let me close this here. So what you're saying is
all
that
right.
I come into my...
Now, listen up closely. I don't want to lose you here, Alex. It's about Tracy. Tracy and traffic lights.
Okay.
You're still not looking. All right, so to get the full flexibility of traffic light control to build your own algorithms, you're going to use tracing. And there are a few functions for controlling traffic lights. I'm starting from the simplest to the most complex. First of all, if you have multiple programs defined for your traffic light, because you loaded them from an XML file, for example, from an additional file, then via tracing you can switch between these programs. Like the morning program and the evening program, and your program, your tracing script decides when the evening starts, when is a good time to switch. That's easy. The next thing, and very important thing, is set phase. So when you call that, the traffic light immediately abandons the current phase, switches to the phase you've given, it's a number, an index in that list of phases, and runs from there. And the nice thing is, after you've set that, it runs by itself. So whatever duration is defined there, it does that and goes to the next phase, goes to the next phase. So if you do it like that, you can leave a lot of work to sumo. Because only when you want to abandon the phase, you switch to the next, for example, and then it runs. You can set the duration of the current phase with this set phase duration function. The thing that gets people confused often is they think they change the cycle for all the successive cycles, but no, it only works for the current cycle. So you have this phase, and by itself it would keep running for another 30 seconds, but you want it to end in 5 seconds, so you set phase duration 5, and then the program keeps running. This is useful if you want to do a coordination, because then you just want to shift all the traffic lights in their cycle. So for each of them, you call the set phase duration, and this gives you this offset, and then they keep running with the old cycle duration, and you have them shift. Then there's set state. Set state lets you just set a list of these letters, A, G, and Y, and then it stays there indefinitely. So if you do that, then you're in control. Sumo will do nothing with the traffic light until you do the next tracing call. And of course, it's quite flexible. You can do everything with that. And then there is this ugly method name. I'm embarrassed to read it, so set complete green state. This thing, it allows you to define the complete program. So via tracing, you can define new programs and then maybe switch between them. And now this is a function that that uses as argument a complex object. And you have to look into the documentation to figure out how to get such an object. Luckily, there's a complementary call, get complete red, yellow, green state. So you get such an object, and you can modify it and load it again, and then you'll have another program in your traffic. This is another way of dealing with the traffic lights. I mostly use the set phase one.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when I'm building a custom actuator controller, this is what I usually do. I define a static program, and I set all the green phases to a very long time, so they won't switch by themselves. Or I set them all to the max duration that I ever want to have. And then I just use the set phase thing to abort when I don't want the green phase to run any longer. And I just go to the transition phase, and then Zumo keeps running into the next green phase. And that's it. So this is the way of dealing with traffic lights that I find very, very useful. Any
yes.
questions? So
the last one was really good.
Okay.
No questions? Did I lose you? It's all too simple.
Do you have a demo script of that last part there, the custom actuator controller via Tracy?
There's a tutorial. It's
okay.
called Tracy for Traffic Lights.
Okay.
It does just that. We can go over the code. Yeah, I guess that would be a good idea. We still have questions. Okay, so for you to follow, in the documentation, there is a tutorial section. I think it's
basic research tutorials.
And then you have the tracing tutorials, and there's one for just cars and one for pedestrian crossings, which is also nice. So, and this basically tells you where to find the tutorial and what it does. So it's a 400 intersection, and it should switch whenever a vehicle comes from here. So this is like a very important direction, and then it should get green to those. And otherwise, it should stay in the horizontal mode. Now, let's look at the code. So, in your Sumo installation, you already have that. It's in docs, Sumo folder docs tutorial. And there you have the Tracy TLS. Now, let's just run this. I hope it works. Basically, we have this cross traffic, and it's in green all the time. I mean, this is already, well, that was 2 minutes of green. The red car comes, gets priority,
rubber.
And the thing keeps running.
You know why this thing will run?
So, clear on what it's supposed to do.
It's the same thing.
Any questions?
Open up the command prompt,
right.
The terminal window in this folder.
So, how is this built? First
yeah.
of all, let's look at.
So what I can do is pull it out.
Let's
here.
Look at the network.
So
what
take
was loaded?
This from my desktop.
So it's really very, very basic. They are
Wait a minute. The tutorial is part of the Sumo installation and C program blah blah blah. Some people might not have write access to this folder. So the Sumo simulation might not run. So it might be a good idea to copy the tutorial folder to some writable destination where it could actually work with it. Just
yeah.
before people try to click it through and
Thank you.
Now it's working?
Right. Yeah. And then,
so
that's the detector.
Again? In the meantime, I can answer questions.
Everybody is busy clicking, Jacob.
No, Alex wasn't clicking.
He's watching.
I'm watching. I did my clicking and now I'm watching. So this may be one of the best things for me to look at as far as documentation in here, because if inside this one, the data, so if I can look at my net XML right here, I will know that plus plus. So that was going to be under here. Well, actually, there's going to be some Tracy thing, right? Ah, oh yeah, I lied. So here's my TL. So these are probably their maximums. And that's all you get for traffic. There's not a whole lot in there, which is fine.
Yeah.
But now, I think what I'm looking at is when I come back under data.
Sure, we should look at the Tracy scope first.
Up here?
I think.
The runner?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think. Okay, usually we start here, right? So
okay.
The libtrack binary import Tracy. Okay. This is just, you can fold this
function.
One. Just fold it to
okay.
Have it more visible.
That's just running it.
It's just running it, just to get the quick feel for the general structure.
Okay.
And here, this is also just a sub function. They start here. If name equals main, this is basically the typical Python way of starting up. So here it's where it's actually starting up. It tries to receive some options. It depends on whether you want to start it without or with GUI.
Okay.
Then you either go for one of these binaries, then you generate a route file, you start Tracy, and then you hit run. So
okay.
The interesting part is probably what's hidden in run, I think.
How do I find run? Oh, right here.
Yeah.
I got it.
This is how I would usually go about trying to debug what's happening in a Tracy file.
Okay.
Okay. So we start at step zero. Then we set the phase for the traffic light with the ID zero to phase two. Okay, which is probably the one where we have the red light for the north and south traffic and the green light for the east and west traffic. Okay. This is where we ask the induction loop and where we try to find out if there is a vehicle that is coming
yep.
from the north. If we have one, so the count would be larger than zero.
Okay.
If we detected a vehicle, then we switch to the other phase of the
three.
Traffic light,
so
which is probably green for the north, south, and yeah.
Actually, it's probably gonna be the yellow. I'm guessing if he has any clearance on there. So this one's probably. Let me see if I got this right. And this is me trying to learn this.
Sure.
So if I come into my data here, so on the network, the net XML.
Yeah.
So on the signal, two should in fact be. Well, this is probably zero, right? One and two.
Zero, one, and two, and three.
Yep, and then when he hits three, it'll just go through the yellow for the 6 seconds right here and then come back to this one. Got it. Okay. So I think I follow that right here.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
it's just what is this zero right here?
The I think this refers to the ID of the particular traffic lights that you want to set the phase
yeah,
on.
Yeah. So if
but
I
you could have multiples, right?
Yep, so this one is right here.
Yeah,
yep, ID
yeah,
zero.
Zero.
Okay. Now, what's interesting is they don't actually have a phase number on here, so that's just
the
index.
The phase numbering is implicit by the order of the statements.
Okay, so he sets it here, which is actually the third one. And right here, if tracing induction loop gets the last vehicle number of...
On the
induction loop,
the zero.
ID zero. Where would that be? So
if you go to the NIMS file, there should be the E1 detector. Maybe it's in the detector
definition.
It's still running.
Right there.
E1 detector zero.
Yep. Got it. Okay. So then under here, so this is going to pull that detector zero. If it's greater than zero.
If I detected a vehicle?
Yep. Okay. And then it'll set that phase three. And then what's going to happen is I think I'll increment a step. As long as that was still greater than zero, it'll keep that going up to the maximum for that signal.
Do we need more time before
okay.
I can continue?
Okay. I think I slowly understand that enough. Luckily, that'll be in the video here, so.
Okay.
I'll go out and expect you to listen. All right, so I've opened up the network file in NetEdit, and I'm looking at the traffic light just to show you that it's a very basic traffic light. You can't even turn at that intersection. So it has one phase, north to south, a transition, another phase east to west, and a transition, and then it would start again. And after 31 seconds, it's going to switch regardless of whether there's traffic coming from the other side. So that's the maximum phase duration here. But whenever a vehicle comes from the north, it's going to switch as soon as possible. So how does that look in the tracing script? I surely have too many files here. And you cannot read this, right? Still need some time to figure out how to make this video. Sorry about that. I'm telling you to listen and then I'm off to the other side. I'm going to use the magnifying. All right. So let's start with this height of curves. It actually starts here in the bottom. So what you should recognize is this call here, this tracy start. We've
so
been doing this
here.
With Robert.
Oops.
So it loads a configuration file, the sumo config, and it configures some output, and that's it. Actually,
you just
there's something it does before. It generates the route file, which is basically, there's some code that writes an XML file.
How do you delete?
But that's not,
oh, yeah.
Not too relevant
delete.
To how the traffic light is controlled, so I'm
yeah.
just going to skip over that.
No.
And then it calls this run method.
Stop.
At the bottom here.
Okay.
I think you do this or add a
and
comma.
And so let's look
okay.
at
one
where
of,
this
one
continues.
Of,
so try this now. So
here
comma.
We have the run method.
Okay. I think comma without a space.
Oh, another logical GND. Shoot.
Okay, but
that's all
so now I just need to fix. That's a different error.
Traffic.
Yes, was.
So you can see
so
it's
now,
not very much.
If I go in here,
first of all, it starts by
put this is just
putting the traffic light into phase two. Now, going back to NetEdit, if I could find the right NetEdit, phase two is this one here. So it's a direction across. All right. Next thing, there's this loop, the simulation step loop. So while you already saw that, and the simulation step. Now the condition here is a little bit different. This is a function that checks whether there are any more vehicles in the network or that are loaded to depart later during the simulation. So basically this runs until every vehicle or flow or trip that was defined has come and gone. So that's a convenient way to deal with different traffic demands and always make sure everything is finished.